One of the main disclosures of modern physics has been that energy reaching the Earth from the Sun is the result of nuclear reactions at the center of the Sun. As the physicist Fridtjof Kappa wrote in his book, The Tao of Physics, and I quote, "Nuclear processes at the center of the Sun are of singular importance for our planet because they furnish the energy which sustain our terrestrial environment. The fact that nuclear energy transmitted by the Sun reaches the Earth in the form of light and sustenance shows that nuclear energy in the hands of nature is a source of light for the world. But the same energy in the hands of men becomes an instrument of death and destruction. What is the reason for this contrasting state of affairs? It is that nature has no power of its own. Whatever it does conforms exactly to the will of God. We the humans, on the other hand, have been invested with freedom. Just as nuclear energy, when it originates from nature in the form of sun rays, is a source of light and sustenance for the planet, so is religion, as revealed to us by God, is a source of light and sustenance for the spiritual world. It nourishes our souls and guides us onto the path of eternal salvation. But just as man have mishandled nuclear energy, they have mishandled religion. They have used it to advance themselves to positions of power, to win esteem, to accumulate wealth for themselves at the expense of others, and to spread conflict, hate, division and suffering in this world. The author Richard Dawkins, in his book, The God Delusion, blames religion for much of the bloodshed in the world and many of the ills in society. It would be wrong to blame nuclear energy for the potential of destruction it holds for us, because that would be due to its misuse, not to any fault of its own. In the same way, it is wrong to blame religion for the evils which man have committed in its name. This is the fault of man, not the fault of the divine religion which he corrupts.